My favorite thing about being an engineer is going to plants and seeing the products that you design actually come into life.
Hi, my name's Riley, and I'm on a mission to talk to as many engineers as I can about their lives designing the world around them. Today, I'm talking to an engineer who's also a maker. I want to find out what makes him so good at his job and how he engineered his future. Ready? Let's go. Hey, Alvin.
Hey, Riley.
So I'd love to hear what you do at work as an engineer.
So I work at a place called Inteva Products. It's in Vandalia, Ohio. And as an engineer, we make car interiors. So you're thinking dashboards, the center console where you might put your drink or your phone, and also doors.
Really? So what type of cars have you made dashboards for?
So the last program I worked on was the Corvette.
Really?
So very fast car. We made the center console for it, and we also made the dashboard. And currently I'm working on a new SUV that'll be coming out next year.
So do you work alone, or do you have a team?
We work in a team of engineers. So it'll be engineers with different jobs, and we all depend on one another to come together and make a car that meets the customer's specifications.
I'm in school, and often I'm being put in groups, and that's not really something I enjoy. But for somebody who does all the time, do you have any tips?
I would say group work can definitely be a little hard sometimes, especially as an engineer. Typically, engineers get the stereotype of loners or do-it-yourself type people. But you'll realize that oftentimes you do have to actually work with other people.
Yeah.
So I would say when working with other people, be patient and also look at what you can learn from somebody else.
Yes, sir. So besides work, you seem like you enjoy your job. What things do you like to do in your free time?
So in my downtime, I like to garden. I like to play with my pets. I have a dog. His name's Ranger, and then a dog named Nala. And then I also am a founding member of the Westside Makerspace, so I spend a lot of time there.
Tell me a little bit more about the Westside Makerspace.
So the Westside Makerspace here in Dayton, Ohio, is a cooperative and worker-owned makerspace. A makerspace is basically a space where community members can come and use tools and equipment and take classes to learn new skills.
Really? That's really interesting. What's something cool that you've made at the makerspace?
So recently I just took a class there and we made lamps. So to do that, we used the laser cutter to cut out the base of the lamp. And then we went over to our electronics bench to solder together the wires and the LEDs. I've also been looking at the 3D printers. We have a small 3D printer farm. We have a t-shirt press, and I'm looking forward to getting my hands on some of the sewing machines.
Yes, of course, but I'm curious. Who or what inspired you to become an engineer?
Growing up, I had teachers pushing me forward in math and science. Also my mom, who made sure that I would stand on top of my coursework. And then my dad, who we just worked around the house together, changing the brakes on the car or fixing something around the house.
I can agree with you. My mom and my dad have always been my top supporters. But besides that, let's track back in time. You are such a smart guy. School must have been super easy for you, right?
I wouldn't say that. School, it was definitely difficult. I had it easier going through middle school and high school, but once I went to college, it was definitely a different level, so I spent a lot of time in the library.
Really?
Yep.
Did you ever have any challenges when it came to when you were younger in school as a person of color, or even today?
I would say challenges came when I went into college. It was a different environment, seeing a lot of people that weren't necessarily from my neighborhood. But even in college, even if you're a person of color at a predominantly white school, you can still find your people and find what makes you comfortable. So that will help.
I agree with you. I actually have a lot of experience in a predominantly white school and as if like a handful of black students. And I definitely had to find my people. It was a little bit harder, but I eventually did it. But looking back to when you were younger, do you think that there was anything that you could have done that might have helped you achieve your goal of engineering?
I could have took more calculus classes if the option was there. So if you have an opportunity to take more classes, definitely take that on earlier so it'll help you later in life.
So how can a kid my age get to where you are?
If you think of something that you might be passionate about or just curious about, I would say at your age, explore it. So even if you're good at math and science, you know, don't slack off on the social studies and the English. because once you get older, you'll find that all of those things will make you a well-rounded, not only engineer, but a well-rounded person.
Thank you so much for being with me here today and showing me how you engineered your future. Bye, Alvin.
Bye, Riley.
Mission accomplished.
Pretty good.